This country has a history of immigration-led entrepreneurship. From Google to eBay to Tesla and now Zoom, our lives are shaped by the innovations made by immigrants. Even second-generation ones like Bezos and Jobs have transformed our very existence. On this episode of Mission Driven, we're talking to a first-generation founder, Manny Medina, CEO of Outreach, and engineering manager Rohit Main, here to discuss their experiences with immigration in this country and how it can be made better. Manny, tell us about Outreach.
So Outreach is the leading sales engagement platform. It takes all the actions that a rep does with their customers, so email, calling, sending packages, or sending collateral, and we put it in one pane of glass so that they can improve over time and get better.
How does it actually work for end users, and how has it evolved to support the needs of your customers?
As an inside rep or as an account executive, you have a particular set of accounts, and those accounts have people match to your value proposition in the form of personas. And the second thing is to make sure that you capture the best thinking of the organization, meaning how do you navigate an account? How many people need to be involved? What are the leading indicators of a deal closing or not closing? What is in the language or in the sentiment of a particular communication? So the ability to have all that information in one pane of glass allows us to then feed our machine learning models and then pump that information back into the application in the form of reports for the managers or even tips for the sellers so that the sellers can actually do a better job in engaging.
As someone who's been through the immigration process, how do you pay it forward as an immigrant founder?
I went through a very bumpy immigration process myself, and I don't wish that on anybody. We thrive in diversity and inclusion, and we feel that diversity comes from all walks of life, that we never bring up immigration as a question in the intake process. And once you are accepted, then we figure out what your immigration status is. And that makes a person who is applying feel very comfortable coming here. The moment you show up, we'll make sure that you are in line for whatever is the next steps by completely sponsoring the visa process right away. And we pay the full load of it. And we are very aggressive at trying to recruit immigrants and making sure that they can stay in this country safely. When I came into this country, I run into the cap. So for a period of time, I was actually here illegally, even though I was building product for a very large company and getting my master's in computer science. There was a period of a couple of weeks in which I had no status. I had to be in the job for a year before the company could apply for a green card. And I thought that was unfair because for that year, I could be deported at any point in time for any reason. And all of a sudden, I'm gone. And I don't want anybody to ever have to go through that.
I mean, in a way, I empathize with Manny a lot because, you know, when I came to this country, I had all those fears. I still hear stories about students, especially this year in the situation, who are thinking about going back to their home countries because companies either hire freezing or not offering any more jobs. My heart goes out to those people.
I worry about the people who are caught in the middle of this transition, again, with a government that is actively anti-immigrant. It makes me a little bit sad that there's no more that we can do about it. So my only influence at a broader scale is just making my voice heard and telling my story to as many people as I can and getting others inspired in making the same adjustments as we did and trying to bring more people in.
Manny, I see you're in the office, but are the rest of your employees working from home? Is this the new normal?
I think the pandemic will change everything. I don't know that we're going back to what was considered normal anymore. We're going to have to get used to it, embrace the new normal and find strength in it. I think we're also starting to come off some of the long-held belief that you have to be in the office to be productive, because clearly we're being productive without being in the office. So what that does is that opens up the aperture to hire anywhere in the US or eventually anywhere else in the world. I'm very optimistic about the changes that this has brought about and the fact that, the kind of company we're going to be on the other end of this.
Rohit, I see you're home. What is it like working for Outreach?
It's been a great experience so far. And Outreach is one company where I believe people actually live the company values. We have a very inclusive culture here where everybody's voice is heard and everybody has the opportunity to make an impact. We have different lines of communication with our exec and leadership team. And there's some really smart people who work here. And I have the opportunity to learn from them and grow even further.
Rohit, how has your work changed since COVID?
I believe in a way it's brought all of us together. I now know what the different situation and different challenges people are going through in my team. And people are more open to sharing their experiences. I now know who has kids and who has pets.
How do you feel like the company has supported you and other employees during this time?
I think Outreach and our leaders have been very empathetic about the situation and the challenges that people are dealing with. Manny holds office hours. He does these weekly emails with a video podcast, and or a comms team sending out updates every time, you know, there's an update with the COVID situation or the office reopening or closing. It makes you feel like, you know, you are part of this company and everybody's still thinking about you.
What advice do you have for other companies navigating COVID?
Don't waste a perfectly good emergency. Use it to cement your core values. Your core values are tested. You will feel bad, but is going through this will make you a stronger company. So embrace it. Make everybody part of the process. Don't isolate yourself. Bring the company together and use this as a moment of strength.
How can other companies be more welcoming to immigrants?
We're missing a gear if we don't count on immigrants to come into this country and help us. And I think that this anti-immigrant sentiment is counterproductive, and it goes against what this country is about. I got my citizenship in Fenway Hall. This is such a historic building that is directly tied to the Constitution. And the judge who gave us the oath gave us a stark reminder of, like, remember, everybody who was in this room that put this country together came from somewhere else. And the people who are going to continue to make this country great will have come from somewhere else or can trace their roots from somewhere else. So embrace that.
For somebody who came to this country to study further and who wants to work here and make an impact, I feel Outreach has been very supportive of my ambitions. You know, that kind of gives me a very sense of security that I know that the company that I work for has my back, cares about my immigration status, and knows that if I don't have this job tomorrow, I might be going back home.
At the end of the day, our customers, ourselves, we all need Rohit's mind focusing on the problem at hand. And that is not immigration. That is solving a problem for the customer and having each other's back. If I wasn't here, 650 jobs would not have been created. So I think that there is just this framework that we need to change and think of immigration as a positive thing that brings innovation and jobs, job creation into the country.